Hi guys, Ali here, your personal technical trainer. In this video, I'm going to show you how much control do you have over your user's start menu customization. I'm going to show you how much customization you can do, how many ways or how many methods do you have to enforce those customizations, and show you some enterprise level customization as well. Some of them you might not be able to practice at home unless you have access to mobile device management solutions such as Intune. In Windows 11, the start menu is redesigned with a simplified set of apps that are arranged in a grid of pages. These are not folder groups or different size applications, but if you like, you can group the applications together. There are three major areas in Windows Start menu. Pinned, which shows a list of the pinned applications. If you want, you can create a list of applications that you need to make available for your users and enforce those applications to be pinned to their Start menu using the group policy. Also, we have the All Apps, which shows an alphabetical list of all the applications that are installed on that specific computer. Again, this can be customized using group policy or MDM devices as well. And lastly, the last area is the recommended area. Under the recommended area, Microsoft Windows recommends the last recent open files or the files and applications that think user might be interested in opening them. All these sections and areas are customizable using group policy. Let's take a look at some of the customizations that are available in Windows 22 H2. If you go to the Start menu, Settings, Personalization, and select the Start menu, you have the new option to change the view. You can select the default mode, which has three rows of pinned applications and a big large area for recommended, or you can say, I need more applications to be pinned and select more pins. With this approach, you have 4 to 5 rows of pinned applications, or you can switch to more recommendations that gives you 2 rows of pinned application and more recommendation. Also, you have the option to change show recently added applications, toggle this on or off, show most used applications, toggle that on or off, and lastly, show recently opened items or opened files in File Explorer on and off. Also, you have the option to use the empty real estate that we have between the profile picture and the shutdown button. If you select the folders, you see that these options are available for you as a toggle to turn on or turn off. I can go ahead, enable the File Explorer, and now we can see that the File Explorer is added to the Start menu. If you want, you can also group applications together. For example, I can just select one app and drag it to the next application that I want, and they would be placed into a folder. By clicking on that folder, I have the option to give it a name, tools, and hit enter. Now I have a group. If you need to unpin an application and remove it from your Start menu, just right-click and unpin from the start. And accordingly, if you want to pin an application, you just right-click on that application and pin it to your Start menu. You can also take the Start menu customization one step further and taking it to group policy. If you go to your group policy, gpedit.msc, and browse the computer configuration, administrative template, start menu, and taskbar. Here you see there is a large list of options that we can set and customize based on our needs. There are two sections, computer configuration and user configuration. If you also go to the administrative template under the user configuration, there is a start menu and taskbar as well. Depending on how we would like to enforce these policies based on the user, regardless of which computer they're logging into, or based on the computer, regardless of what user is logging into, we can set our policies. Let's take a quick look at some of these options. For example, disable context menu in the start menu. As you see, they are very self-descriptive. And even if you need a little bit more help with understanding each one of these, you can easily double click it and read the description. The descriptions are very descriptive and self-explanatory. It even also tells you which windows can use this policy, and if you set this policy, which operating systems would be affected. And lastly, the most advanced method for designing and exporting your start menu layout is configuring a start menu the way you want it for all your users, exporting it to a JSON file, and then creating a policy using your mobile device management such as Intune. So we're going to show you the steps of how you're doing it and how you configure the MDM. Imagine that this is the source computer you want to configure. I would like to make sure that the mail application is removed from the start menu. I don't like the pins. Maybe I would like to go ahead, do a little bit of personalization, go to the start, make sure that I have more pins available, go back to start, and rearrange these applications. Let's say I would like to group to do with Zoom and Windows Sandbox with tools, just as an example. Now that I have done my configuration and I have arranged all the applications that I want to pin, it's time to export these settings. In order to do so, we need to open a PowerShell command as administrator. Go to the start menu, search for PowerShell, and run as administrator. From here, we need to export the settings using the command export-start layout, and then give it a path when we want to save it. Hit enter, and your file is exported. If we go and take a look at our file, we see that we have a JSON file. I'm going to open this JSON file using Visual Studio Code. You can use any other JSON editor that you would like. In this JSON file, you see the applications that have pinned are listed here in the order. If you want, you can reorganize them, and that's the way that they would be displayed. What you need is only the pinned section. So I'm gonna select the pinned list and copy it in a notepad file because that's what we're going to use when we are importing it into our MDM policy. Now that we have created our JSON file, we log into our MDM device solution. In this case, I'm using Intune as our endpoint manager. From here, you go to the configuration profiles, create a new profile. Under the select platform, select what operating systems are you going to affect. In our case, Windows 10 or later. Profile type would be a template and a custom template. Select next. You need to give it a very descriptive name. In this case, I'm going to give it Windows 11 Start Customization. Description, up to you, but make sure to use a very descriptive description so you can find what you have done in the future. Select next. Now it's time to add the configuration settings. Click add, name, give it a descriptive name, something like Win11 custom start layout. Description, just select whatever description that you need. For the OMA value, you have to set a specific value. And that's this value. and type would be string. What do we copy in this string? The file from our JSON file. So we need the list of all the applications that we would like to pin. Copy them and paste them in the value. Click save and your policy is created. On the next step, you just need to assign it to the groups or devices that you would like to apply the policy. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. Make sure to hit the bell icon to be notified when the new content is released. Thank you for watching and hope to see you on the next video.